licoricey flavors, so if you're not a fan of that big black licorice flavor, I recommend taking a sip before you take a big smell of this. A lot of that anise is carried on the nose. The third ingredient is wormwood. And wormwood is interesting. It's the ingredient that the ban was based on. As you might have heard, absinthe was illegal up until 2007 in America and throughout most of the world for most of the 20th century because people thought that it made you hallucinate. Now, this is not entirely wrong. Of course, any kind of alcohol consumed in sufficient quantities can make you hallucinate. But absinthe has no special hallucinogenic qualities to it. Wormwood is a very mild muscle relaxant and an excellent anesthetic, so you might feel your tongue going a little bit numb or the aches and pains easing out of your shoulders, but you shouldn't see anything too crazy, at least in that, not unless you've very much overindulged. So we're going to perform what's called the traditional preparation of absinthe today, which involves pouring the liquor through a sugar cube perched up on a slotted spoon over a goblet here. I'll do these a few at a time so you'll be able to see the effect. After we've poured the liquor through the sugar, we're going to set that sugar on fire. We're going to flambe it just a touch. That's not so much to caramelize the sugar as it is to just break down some of the starch so the sugar will mix more easily into the drink. Start us off with three. Now you'll notice that it pours this beautiful clear emerald color, and then as the water hits it, it's going to start to cloud up a little bit. So I've got these started. I'll throw a little bit of light on that for you so you can see the effect of what they call the louche. Starts to cloud up a little bit. They say you can see the little green fairy start to dance in the body of the bowl. And so, I'll get this one here.
I love this piece.
Yes.